So a little while ago, this 2003 Sonic Blue Terminator Cobra popped up on like a Copart page, like a wrecked auction site page, and the car was being sold. Obviously, it was wrecked, and some people were considering buying the car and fixing it. And usually what happens is it ends up going to a company that's going to part the car out. You can see the damage on this side's pretty bad, but I've seen worse. I think my GT was actually about this bad, if not maybe a little worse than this. And I was able to repair mine, but that was a choice I decided to make. It's sad when you see the back of the car looks really good and the rest of the car looks really good. It's really sad to see this car as such a desirable car and not want to fix it. The interior looks really good for the mileage. You'll actually be very surprised when you find out the mileage on this car. If you look, the dash looks good, seats look good, everything looked really good on this car. And I was actually very surprised when I saw how many miles this car actually had on it. And so, good running car though, and it looks like it was taken care of, and it's a very neat car. The Sonic Blue was only offered in 2003 on the Terminator Cobras. You could not get an 04 Terminator Cobra in Sonic Blue, so it's pretty cool to see. And with the stock pulley shroud on there, I imagine that this car was lightly modified, maybe an exhaust system, but doesn't look like it was pulleyed and tuned like most of them are, which probably helps with the longevity and the reason why this one had such higher mileage. If you look at the VIN number, you see that Y in the center. That's the supercharged Terminator Cobra distinction. So pretty cool to see that. It really is a true Terminator. And when you have a car that's wrecked like this, it looks a lot better when you take the body panels off and actually see. So we'll get to that in a second here. But here's the big surprise, 243,000 miles on it. So this car definitely got some good use before its life was ended. And now another company has bought the car that is known for parting these cars out. So some people would say, well, good for them because we do want parts for these cars. Some people would say it still could have been fixed. I think that's a debate that will never have an actual answer to it because some people are going to feel differently than others. But it's definitely a car that was well used and enjoyed. And I've seen them with over 300,000 miles on them, so that's pretty good to see. And I'm not sure if this car has had an engine rebuild or a replacement or anything. It's hard to ever know unless you talk to the previous owners of the car. But with the body panels stripped away, it actually doesn't look so bad. It looks about like my silver one was, my GT, when I fixed it. And so I think this one probably could have been saved pretty easily, but it just depends on what people are willing to do. With higher mileage, I think that's the reason why nobody wanted to fix this one, because at the end of the day, they'd put a lot of money into it and have a high mileage car. But it all depends. Some people wouldn't care about that as long as they have a real Terminator Cobra. But look at the seats. For that kind of mileage, the seats actually look really good. I would assume these are the original seats to the car. It's always possible they were replaced at some point, but not very likely. I think these are the original seats. So pretty good to see. I think they held up very well, and I think the car overall was a pretty nice car, especially given the mileage. I've seen a lot of cars with high mileage that are very well taken care of, and they look like lower mileage cars as well. So you can see the seats look pretty good. The back seats have the buckle marks where they've been folded down. That usually will pop out when the seats sit for a little bit. So dashboard looks good. I've seen dashes that were cracked really bad. And, you know, this one looks to be in pretty good shape. The steering wheel has a little bit of wear on the top, but I've seen worse. I've seen cracked and peeling, you know, chunked out steering wheels. And so it actually looks really good for what it is. So again, here's another look at the dash and this just a little bit of, you know, the HVAC controls and everything over here. So standard looking interior here. Doesn't look like it was modified. There's not stickers all over it and stuff like that. Just looks like a nice car. So really unfortunate to see that's being parted out, especially when you look at the rest of it like this in good shape. So anyway, this one will be sold for parts. Maybe somebody will buy the shell, turn it into a race car. Who knows? But thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. I love reading your comments, so leave those below. I appreciate all the positive feedback I get on all the videos. So thanks for watching and stay tuned for more Mustang content.